Hi, I'm Jackie.
And I'm Jordan, and we're from Tehama Group Communications.
We are making this video to help you film your testimonial for your affiliated group. We understand that these are unprecedented times, and we want to offer our support and guidance to help make the best content we can this semester.
So here's a helpful tutorial on the basics of lighting, framing, sound, and aesthetic specifics. Don't worry, we know that it sounds like a lot, but it really is quite easy once you get the hang of it, and it looks amazing on camera.
First up, we're going to talk about lighting. Here are some tips and tricks to keep in mind when lighting your shot. Try not to use harsh lighting or overexposed lighting. Your audience really wants to be able to see you to understand your message, and they can't do that if there is harsh light creating shadows over your face, or if the shot is overexposed, which means it is too bright for us to be able to see you. Instead of using that lighting, try to use softer lighting. Softer lighting can be achieved by one of the following. If you're choosing to shoot outside, try to shoot at sunrise or sunset when the light is softest. Try to avoid noon or early afternoon filming times, as the light will be extremely harsh. If you're choosing to film inside, I recommend one of the following things. Use the lights you have. Typically, inside lighting is much softer than outside daylight, so use what you've got. Use your ceiling light, a big lamp, a desk lamp, something that will give the allure of warmth and comforting.
Next, we have framing. Make sure before you do anything else that you're filming horizontally like this. Any vertical video submissions will not be accepted. Now, you're going to need to film in a medium close-up shot. That means that the bottom of your screen is going to cut off upper mid-chest level, and you're still going to allow for a little bit of headroom at the top of the screen. For this video, we recommend filming on your smartphone because not only is the video quality pretty nice, but the audio also will sound better when comparing it to a laptop or a computer recording.
Speaking of audio, here are some things to consider when you're filming your testimonial in regards to audio. We want to be able to clearly and fully hear you. This means try not to film when there's a train going by, or if there's an ambulance going by. This can deter away from your message, and then we won't be able to fully understand what you're trying to tell us. Obviously, these things we cannot control, but it's important to do the three following things. One, notice that the noise is happening. Sometimes when you're filming, you completely zone into what you're doing and forget the outside world. However, it is important to notice when noises are happening that are out of your control. Number two, pause what you're doing. As soon as you notice the noise is happening, pause what you're saying. And number three, continue when the noise is over. When it comes to answering questions during your testimonial, please remember the following things. Rephrase the question that you are being asked to answer. So, for example, if the question is, "What is your favorite color?" you would say, "My favorite color is purple." Something like that. This is going to ensure that even if the audience doesn't know what questions you're asked to respond to, they will know what you are trying to get across because you have rephrased the question.
Let's move on to the aesthetic specifics. In terms of dress code, we recommend wearing something that fits to your own business's image. When picking a background for your video, try to highlight your business's best features. For example, if you're a boutique, try having some of your favorite products in the background. Or if you're a restaurant, you could film in one of your favorite dining spots. Remember, you're on camera and your video will be representing your brand's image. When you send your footage back to us, please send in one video per response question.
We wish we could be there to help you in person, but we hope this video has been helpful in substitution of in-person direction.
Let's make this video content the best we possibly can right now. If you have any questions, feel free to email us.
Thank you for watching, and don't forget to shoot horizontally. Bye!